You know, you got DeGrom. The stat that I heard, I think Ed Coleman said it the other day, Jacob DeGrom's last 50 starts. Mm-hmm. I believe his ERA is ridiculous in them. I think the Mets have won 16 games.
Yeah, it's something like that. It's
Could
crazy.
Could you imagine?
I know.
And so when Mickey Callaway says you have your ace on the mound, these are games you have to win. Not only don't they win them, they lose them at an alarming. And I'm not saying he got 16 wins. The Mets have only won 16 of those games.
Right.
That is astounding.
To not be able to take advantage when you have a guy that you could make the case, certainly last year was the best pitcher in baseball, and this year is in the short, on the short list. To not be able to take advantage of his starts is just alarming. It's partly the offense. Obviously, it has to do with the defense. It certainly has to do with the bullpen.
Right.
We know that. The Mets are a flawed team in how they are constructed, and yet they have some pieces that are among the most attractive in baseball.
Right.
And that's where I think I know I get pulled in to the idea they can still turn this around. There is still time. They could go on a great streak. I bought in, you know, the idea the Nationals just did it. The Mets certainly are capable of doing it, and I believe that. I just now believe it's almost certainly too late.
Well, you're at the point. You got to make us believe at this point.
Right. Oh, 100%. I agree.
Just, it's too much.
I agree with that.
You know, but you're right. You've got those pieces in McNeil and Alonso. And Alonso is must-see TV. I mean, when he's up, you want to watch his at-bat.
His at-bats are fun. They are often productive. Jeff McNeil is a magician with the bat. I love watching him hit. The two of them as a 1-2 punch, you know, they need a little help. They need a little help in that lineup, but they're a really, really good 1-2 punch. Imagine if Cano were Cano and if Cespedes were healthy. Of course, neither of those things is true. Because the glass can be half full at times for the Mets. It can never be a drip over half full. Never. Never. So when something good happens, something bad happens. And that's how it feels when you're watching the Mets over time, but particularly this season.
Yep. It seems like one step back, three are forward, and three back. And that's what the season's been all year long.